Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. Coming up on this week's show, the iPhone 4 launches in China. A robot power suit gives users superhuman strength, and Sharp gets into the e-reader business. We'll start this week with the BlackBerry PlayBook, a tablet aimed at RIM's core audience of enterprise users. The first PlayBook uses Wi-Fi, and RIM plans 3G and 4G versions later. The device can be paired with a user's existing BlackBerry via Bluetooth, providing access to all of the email and content on the phone.
You've already got a BlackBerry, you've already have an account, you're already paying for it, it's already connected into the BlackBerry Enterprise server, it's already being controlled and managed from IT. You already know how to use it. All the data's already been sent to your BlackBerry. Why send it again?
It has a 7-inch screen, front and rear high-definition cameras for both video capture and video conferencing, and an HDMI output for showing presentations on a big screen display. It supports both Adobe Flash 10.1 and Adobe Air, as well as HTML5 and Java. The tablet features a 1 GHz dual-core processor and 1 GB of RAM. RIM expects the PlayBook to go on sale through retail stores and other channels in the US early next year, and in other markets beginning in the second quarter. Apple launched its iPhone 4 in China over the weekend, where more than 1,000 people waited outside the store, some in line for 2 days, to get their hands on the phone. The launch in China comes 3 months after it debuted in the US. In the first 4 days, China Unicom has sold close to 100,000 phones. With more than 800 million subscribers, China's cell phone market is the largest in the world, and smartphones are slowly gaining market share. Apple currently holds 7% of the Chinese smartphone market, ranking the company 5th behind Nokia, Samsung, Motorola, and Sony Ericsson. Nintendo's 3DS, the first portable game device with a 3D screen, will go on sale in Japan in February and launch in Europe, Australia, and the US in March. The 3DS is the biggest upgrade the DS handheld has seen since it first debuted in 2004. It's gaining buzz because it doesn't require the user to wear 3D glasses. Instead, a filter over the display splits the on-screen image, providing the illusion of depth. Nintendo also showed a prototype program that makes use of the camera to merge people's faces.
また開発中に社内では話題になったのが、外側と内側のカメラを同時に使う合体カメラです。ちょっとご覧ください。これは試しに私と宮本の顔を合成してみたものです。向かい合って、それぞれの枠の中に顔を入れてシャッターボタンを押すだけです。
Nintendo said it hopes to sell 4 million 3DS units and 15 million software titles for it in roughly 1 month between its launch and the end of March. We'll give you a quick recap of two electric cars that debuted at the Paris Auto Show this week. France-based Renault showed off the Désir all-electric car that has a range of 160 kilometers or about 100 miles. Its body is lightweight and made from Kevlar. It can do 0 to 60 in about 5 seconds and has a top speed of 180 kilometers an hour, or about 112 miles per hour. And Kia debuted the Pop, an electric concept car. The car seats 3 people and measures 3 meters long. Inside, there's a transparent organic LED or TOLED screen that displays speed, battery charge, and other information. The Pop's top speed is 140 kilometers an hour, or about 87 miles per hour, and like the Désir, it also has 160 kilometer range. Sony Ericsson has unveiled a remote control with a 1.3-inch screen that will allow Android smartphone users to view Facebook and Twitter updates and control their phone's music player. Called LiveView, the device connects to the phone via Bluetooth and can also be used to see missed calls, incoming text messages, and view RSS feeds. It works with most smartphones running Android 2.0 or higher, and the gadget measures 35x35x11mm and is controlled using buttons. It will start shipping in the fourth quarter for about $110. Sharp is getting into the ebook reader business with two new Android-based devices, one with a 5.5-inch screen and another with a 10-inch screen. Sharp plans to introduce an ebook store in Japan in December to coincide with the launch and hopes to sell 1 million units within their first year of sale. Talks with Verizon Wireless means the US is likely to be the second place to see them sometime in 2011. Sharp says they're meant to compete with products like Amazon's Kindle and Sony's Reader, but thanks to their bright, colorful LCD screens and shiny cases, they're sure to draw comparisons with tablet PCs like Apple's iPad and Samsung's Galaxy Tab. Pricing and full technical details will come closer to the launch. Raytheon unveiled its second-generation Exoskeleton, or XOS2 robotic suit this week that gives the user superhuman strength. The new suit is lighter, faster, and stronger than its predecessor, and also uses 50% less power.
Well, there are two main focuses. One is like the combat variant, which would actually be just from the legs down, and it would support a backpack to lighten the soldier's load. The other variant is logistics.
Clearly, lifting weights in the battlefield, like water bottles and food rations and munitions and that sort of thing, is not a stretch from lifting a 200-pound barbell.
The suit is powered by high-pressure hydraulics and allows the user to lift 200 pounds several hundred times without tiring and punch through 3 inches of wood, among other tasks. The suit was developed for the U.S. Army, and Raytheon predicts that a tethered suit could be on the battlefield in 5 years and an untethered version in about 8 to 10 years. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. Next week, I'll be reporting from CTEC in Tokyo, and we'll, of course, bring you all the latest news and gadgets, so be sure to stay tuned. To find out what's coming up, follow us on Facebook and Twitter. As we head out this week, we'll leave you with some more shots from the Paris Auto Show. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week from Japan.